would challenge anybody in this room to tell me what scientific miracle takes place when you relocate an apple from under the millions of apple trees in Michigan closer to a young man's deer stand in Calcasas. I'll tell you what happens. Nothing. Russ Mason, chief of the DNR, admitted if you hunt deer over bait and feed, you are not a conservationist. How dare he? The law banning feeding and baiting in Michigan is going to chase hunting families out of the sport for absolutely no reason. If a disease can be transmitted by nose-to-nose contact, there is not a damn thing you can do about it. Because the minute a deer is born, they lick and groom and swap spit. They all go to a licking branch. If you don't know what a licking branch is, there's one every couple acres in Michigan. And every deer chews the branch. Every deer shares preorbital gland. Every deer licks it and chews on that branch, and every subsequent deer absorbs that body fluid. It's happening right now while I'm sitting here. You can't ban that. That's what deer do. I have given you no opinions here today. I live with deer every year of my life. It is my soul cleansing quality of life mantra. The scientists must not do that, because if they think they could stop deer from swapping spit, they're idiots. I recommend they stay in the lab, wear their white jackets, and shut up. Let people who live with the deer make decisions based on what the deer do. I rest my case.